why Khadi is special. But what are the challenges before Khadi? And we all know that it has got a great heritage, a great legacy. But what are the different challenges before Khadi? If we all have to think and we have to have a roadmap, what would that roadmap be? We have many resources, you know, great heritage and history and environmentally, ecologically friendly fabric and everything. But we also have a lot of challenges. I think this is just a platform where experts like you, I know there are experts from very many verticals, from business, from technology, from you all have very long years of experience. You know what exactly should be done. My request would be, please tell us, if you are the decision maker, if this was your baby, what would you like to do or what would you like to be done for this particular sector? I would be extremely grateful if you all could actually come up with, not necessarily today, maybe tomorrow, maybe day after, maybe after a week, after 15 days, after a month, if some ideas come to you, or if you want to really come forward and really help this cause, please feel free to share it with us. Please tell us that this is what is happening and that needs to be changed. And changed like this, so that at least it's going to help the cause, help the people, help the artisans. Let me tell you something quite interesting. I mean, I don't know whether you know it. You know, ever since Khadi was there, every time people used to report around 11 lakh artisans, okay, involved in the Khadi sector. A few years back, when all accounts were Aadhaar seated and it was decided that every help incentive to be given to the Khadi artisan has to go through direct benefit transfer. Do you know all that figure has actually come down to realistic something like 4,75,000 or something, I was told. So now every incentive which goes to these people go to their bank account through direct benefit transfer. Now we need to really look at not just 4.75 lakh and the other people who are dependent on that, but we want to really expand this. If we want to have international collaboration, we need to look at the standards, the quality. You know, we can't just, and another thing which I would like to really share, that no two pieces of Khadi are identical. They are different. You know, many times people who export, they think, okay, this was like this, but this particular piece of cloth is different. It has to be different. But it is handcrafted. It is not machine made. Khadi is premium. Khadi is niche. So we have to keep that in mind. What does technology have to do in Khadi? Somebody may just question. I think we have to really think differently. How can technology come? I just give you one example, you know, that how through technology, now every incentive which is going to be Khadi artisan from the ministry is going through their bank account. So it's not going here and there, you know, like nobody knows what's happening. Number two, can we use technology to ensure that credit is made available to these people, you know, working capital or whatever, in time, and a low cost credit? Number three, how can we use technology to have better marketing facility, better market access, not just inside the country, outside also? Now, government has decided to have 4 design houses. For the first time, we got it approved by the cabinet that we are going to have 4 design houses across the country for Khadi exclusively. I think this is one of the biggest challenges that Khadi faces. How do we update, how do we do it so that people, the young brigade, the young and the aspirational, people who can afford to buy a 3,000 or 4,000 rupees shirt, you know, how do we attract them? So design, I would also request all of you who have some ideas about this, how do we go about it? How do we do this design house so that people who actually have an idea, how can it be taken on board? Then, for example, suppose the charkha that we are using now, the new model charkha. The charkha is not the charkha that we associate with Mahatma Gandhiji. The charkha looks different. How can we reduce the weight of that charkha? Now we are discussing with some experts from IITs and all that. How do we use the technology so that the weight of the charkha, the cost of the charkha can be reduced? It can be made more efficient. Why does somebody have to go through the drudgery and use so much of force? If you haven't visited, I would request you please visit some of the in the rural areas and other places where actually, and mostly women actually who are doing this this hand woven and hand spun and handcrafted thing. Can we reduce their drudgery by use of technology? And we have Raymond's, we have many others who are already collaborating with KVIC. Now my request is, please nurture this as your own baby. Can we not position it some international exhibitions? Can we not really position it? In fact, now we are also planning to have two films made on Khadi. One for the domestic audience, because the connection, the attraction would be different. And one for the international audience, where people are more interested in ecologically, sustainable fabric. That Mr. Saxena was talking about, use of water and things like that. So we are now trying to have two films made on this. Now from the ministry also, we would request, people would obviously volunteer to get these films done. I mean, government can do it. I mean, it's not going to cost us a heavy amount of money. I mean, that's absolutely sure. But why can't somebody else make this money? I mean, why can't we really make this films which is going to be attractive to one and sundry all across the world? And we have to look at those niche markets where there can be value addition. And that is how Khadi can prosper. If you can have value addition and that money goes to the artisan. Otherwise, we'll not have people who will be attracted to this hand weaving, hand spinning and all that stuff. Unless they get good amount of money. Because somebody can just go and do a manrega work and earn 200 rupees a day. Why would that person actually work here for 8 hours if he doesn't get, at least 300 or 400 rupees per day? So I think my request is, please come up with this, please own, please nurture. Let's all work together. And I know Mr. Malia has come from Intel and there are other also experts who are here. My request is, please share with us what you can possibly do and you can contribute to this great cause, which is going to help not just in having a great brand from India, like yoga, for example. Everybody in the world knows that yoga emanated from India. So everybody knows Khadi emanated from India. Let's position this brand. Let's all come together and work. And I would also request the media that they have a huge role to play to really position Khadi as a niche product before the people of this country, and not just people of this country, but the countries abroad. Thank you very, very much. And I again congratulate CII and everyone who has come over to actually help this cause. Thank you very, very much.